to Peterson. I'm a reporter at Digiday. Today, let's talk about how the programmatic auction model is changing and how advertisers are adopting a method called bid shading to try to make sure that those changes don't lead them to overpay for impressions, but how bid shading could lead to ad tech companies pocketing more of the money that advertisers are spending on programmatic advertising. So pretty much every time a web page loads, there are auctions that run in the background to fill the ad slots on the page. So in this case, an ad exchange says, hey, I've got an ad impression here, advertisers who wants it. Advertiser one says, okay, I'm willing to pay $5 for that impression. Advertiser two doesn't know how much advertiser one's willing to pay, but says, I'm willing to pay $4 for that impression. Auctioneer goes, okay, $5 is the highest bidder. You win the bid. But instead of having to pay the $5 that they bid, advertiser one ends up only having to pay a penny more than the second price bid or the runner-up bid. So they pay $4.01. That's how programmatic auctions have traditionally run, but over the past 2 years, there's been a shift to a first price auction model, most recently and most notably with Google's ad exchange adopting first price auction. So a first price auction is basically what we think of as a normal auction in the real world. Ad impression goes up for bid, advertiser one says, hey, I'll pay $5. Advertiser two says, hey, I'll pay $4. $5 is more than $4. So advertiser one wins the bid, but they have to pay the $5 that they bid, which is fine, super straightforward, but in a second price model, that advertiser could have paid $4.01 instead of $5. That money adds up, and so advertisers have had to figure out a way to not have to pay quite so much in a first price auction model. Bid shading is a method that ad tech companies have come up with to try to make sure that advertisers aren't overpaying by as much in a first price auction model. Basically, advertiser sets their bid at $5, but before the bid actually goes through to the auction, the ad tech companies will have an algorithm kind of figure out, okay, is $5 actually how much this advertiser has to pay in order to win the impression? Or is it possible that, you know, it could go for cheaper? Would the runner-up only be paying $4, in which case maybe we don't need to bid as much as $5. They may not know that they could only bid $4 and a penny in order to get the impression, but they might be able to surmise based on historical pricing data, the publisher running the impression, the type of ad that it is, the audience it's targeted to, that, you know what, actually we could probably get this for $4.50. And so that's how bid shading works. So bid shading is actually working. According to PubMatic, Rubicon Project, and the Trade Desk, which all do bid shading or offer bid shading for advertisers, advertisers on average are saving 20% off their bids as a result of using bid shading in a first price auction model. Now, 20% is a tough pill to swallow for publishers who are losing that, you know, 20% of their revenue per impression. But bid shading is actually becoming something of a tough pill to swallow for advertisers as well. So advertisers are getting worried that bid shading is a way for ad tech companies to be a little shady if they wanted to. In the example, first price auction, advertiser one bids $10, advertiser two bids $5. Advertiser one has an ad tech company with a bid shading tool that figures out, oh, you actually don't have to pay $10, you can pay a lot less. And let's say the ad tech company tells the advertiser, you know what, you could pay $7 and still win this impression, so let's bid $7. Advertiser says, great, I'm saving $3, I'm happy. But what if the ad tech company actually knows that the advertiser could have gotten it for $6 and is instead telling the advertiser, bid $7 and keeping that extra dollar for themselves? Now, do advertisers, are they able to know if this is going on?
Huh?
Not really. And that's becoming a problem with bid shading.